hear a snout. Where is it? Oh, there it is. This is trippy. That ship in the bottle. So with the sound, like that's not making any sound when it fell. Hobby horse. How do you use it? Didn't say. Once again, it didn't say. See, I don't know how to use the hobby horse. I'm guessing you have to do something with that, or not. I don't know how to use the hobby horse. It's a weapon, but I don't know how to use it. It's just frustrating. See, they need to test their game. Like, they didn't. It's obvious that they just ported it over to PC. They didn't bother to play through it to make sure everything ported over smoothly, obviously, because, like, for instance, this game by default plays at 30 frames per second. You have to go into a config file in order to make it play above 30 frames per second. You know, you have to tweak something in the config file. You know, it's obviously, like, it's a lot of these port games do that, especially games with the Unreal Engine. You know, you always the game never runs smooth out of the box. You have to go and tweak something. And it's like in this age and day and age, you have to go into a config file instead of in the options, you know, where it should be. You know, it's like, I don't understand. But then again, maybe just maybe they want, ideally want this game to play at 30 frames per second, even though it's not really smooth on a PC, as opposed to if you do 30 frames per second on a console, it tends to feel a little bit smoother, but on a PC, it doesn't feel smooth at all. But, yeah, so, yeah. Alright, and I forgot what I was going to say. A snout. Snout made me forget. But yeah, oh, okay, now I remember. The performance issues. Like, this thing drops to 30 when you do this. I have it on high physics. It drops to 30 frames per second. So if I had it capped at 30 frames, I would see no performance loss. You know? Because it's capped at 30 frames. It never drops below 30. In the most intense scenes, it never drops below 30. But just like in that fight with all that shit going on and like with ooze and clouds and smoke and debris and everything. And a bunch of enemies on the screen. It never drops below. So maybe they did that. It's something wrong with the engine or something with the game, you know. That, you know, that's why they capped it. You know, they need to patch it.
Grave news. The ship was crushed and her crew lost.
People have, people who decide to play this on the computer, they have good computers.
Fitting out polar expeditions is a needless.
Especially this type of title, you know, it's not like, you know, something basic like, or popular like World of Warcraft or Starcraft or even Diablo later where, you know, you might have to make a engine or have the graphics load to run on a wide range of systems, but like most people who are buying this game are most likely going to get it on the PlayStation 3 or Xbox, you know, and most people who don't have good computers, you have maybe a decent computer to play WoW, they most likely have a console, you know, to do that because it's cheaper. You can, you know, it has a lot of games on the console, so why spend extra money on the PC if you're not gonna do. I did do a new tweak though to it I found on the internet, and it to help with the loading, like when it would load a new area, it would drop for whatever reason, like 20 frames. It's not doing that. It's been quite smooth. And even when there's a lot of like this ooze, this liquid, this fluid shit, even with that, it's a lot smoother. Even though the frame rate is dropping a bit, you know, it's a lot. It's not jerky. I guess that's the best way to describe it. So I might probably increase that number that I tweaked after this session to see if what that does. See if I can get it a little bit even more smoother. Alright, of course. I don't even know where I am. Where am I? Okay. Invisible wall. You know, and like I said in like video, I think it was number 7, that this game is not intense on my card or my system. Like my temperature is really, like on my GPU, it never went above 60 degrees Celsius, usually like on a 580 GTX, you know, non-water cooled, you know, super clock. I'm usually in a high intensive game, so like The Witcher, it's like getting up to 80, you know, in intense load, on intense load.
crushed.
So they need to either put a patch or something. NVIDIA needs to put out a driver or something.
Competition of governments
fix these performance issues, because it's not putting a strain on my system at all, except when the fluid and the smoke from the gun, when you hold it in one place, like that, frame rate drops when you move through it. It's fine when you're not moving through it. But other than that, the game has been running at perfect 60 frames per second. And it looks awesome. Yeah, I don't know how to use the horse at all.